Let's bring in our panel again. Michelle Boag, you heard the comments there from Katrina McLennan. Very strong. She thinks this is a Me Too moment for New Zealand politics. It's almost like it's moved from the law profession onto politics. Would you agree with her?
Well, there's two issues here I'd like to comment on. The first one is Katrina was right in the sense that this is about power and it's about alleged abuse. It's not about sex. And I probably would disagree with my colleagues here that it's not about lifting the bed sheets, as Jamie Lee Ross says. It's actually about how you use the power that you have as a politician. And what I sensed this week amongst the National Party caucus was some very real anger from our women members of parliament. And I think what we're going to see here is a reframing of this issue about the misuse of power from those women who feel very, very strongly. And I think that will be led by the women in the caucus. And they are the ones actually who I think have the responsibility and the capability to just have a look and make sure that the systems that we do have in place at both a party and a parliamentary level are appropriate.
Wayne Mapp, when you were in Parliament, did you get any sense that Jamie Lee Ross, did there were any of these issues? How did people not know?
No, I didn't get a sense. I mean, Jamie Lee Ross has always been an intense sort of person. That's been evident. But on these sorts of things, the answer is no. I mean, have there ever been affairs before in Parliament? Well, you all know the answer to that. The answer is yes. But this is kind of completely beyond what any of us understood. One thing I would pick up, Katrina, about, in fact, which is what you also said, Peter Goodfellow actually handled this pretty well, I think.
Well, he hasn't spoken. We need to talk to him about it.
Katrina Bongard came and saw him to get a remedy, and she actually got it, and she said that today, and that remedy was to get Jamie Lee Ross to stop doing what he was doing, and at least for a while he did. Now, of course, we now know what's happened, but that's a different... week's been different, but she has said that the party, or more particularly Peter Goodfellow, did actually what she asked him to do.
All right, and now Simon Bridges, he insists too, when he first heard about this, and he was not the leader of the party back then, he confronted Jamie Lee Ross.
Yeah,
he did what he was supposed to do.
I mean, whatever National did about this was ineffectual, because you've got Simon Bridges on record as saying he could point to 15 occasions where Jamie Lee Ross did this. So this just went on and on. And it underlines my point that the National Party's response to what the hell was going on over a long period of time was completely ineffectual.
But he and Paula Bennett did confront Jamie Lee Ross.
Tried and failed.
All right. Bryce, the politics of this, where does this go now? I mean, do you think that we've got a Me Too situation with politics now? Is that going to change politics?
Hugely so.
Are people going to start reporting on affairs, for example?
That's the really interesting question, and we've seen this week.
Let's hope not.
We used to have, a very strong delineation between the reporting on politics and on personal lives of politicians, and the media did not go there. The politicians didn't go there. They didn't really used to, bring up what's going on beneath the bed sheets. But of course, now that Jamie Lee Ross has been in the situation, they sort of have to, in a sense. But
let's not get carried away here. As Wayne said, there have been affairs in Parliament for decades. We have two former deputy prime ministers on both sides of the House who started relationships in Parliament, one with a colleague, one with a journalist, and subsequently ended up marrying those people and living happily
ever
after.
So it comes back to the point you made at the start, and this is where, again, the story gets so complicated and difficult, because that's separate from harassment and bullying, which is the
concerning
element here.
I've talked to Melanie Reid about the story she had in Newsroom, which she said she had been working on for a long time, and she said the reason those women who she had been talking to for a long time actually agreed to speak out was when they heard Jamie Lee Ross say, "I respect women, I've never treated women badly." And that was the point where they said, that's not true, therefore I'm willing to put myself on the line and actually tell my story. Mm. And often there is, in this situation, a tipping point like that. And if there is a tipping point into the Me Too situation, it probably came at Jamie Lee Ross's own creation, where he said something that later turned out to be not true.